Hey, what's up? This is Anupam. Welcome back. This is the fifth tutorial on the video tutorial series on STM32F4 Discovery Board. You can check out the website www.logicvoltage.com. You will find all these tutorials there also. You can even check out the video store at the website. You will find very good video tutorial series there with a very less price. People are buying it, talking about it. You can also buy it and I'm sure you will not be disappointed. You can get in touch with me also in case of any query. Just go to contact us page and fill up the form and I will reply. You can check out the forum. For any tutorial related queries, you can post comment there and I will reply back there so that other people can also see the comments and what discussion is going on. Please make some donations so that we can continue to create the free tutorials. You are welcome to choose any amount as you like for donation. We will be highly appreciated. You can also support us by giving a thumbs up at this YouTube video and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks. Okay, in the previous tutorial, we have learned about the frequency concepts of the microcontroller. We have learned how to configure the clock settings in the project. Then we have changed the LED blinking program so that LED will blink in exactly 1 second gap. Now in this tutorial, we will go ahead and move on from discovery board to a breadboard. We will use 4 external LEDs. We will write a program in such a way that our all 4 LEDs will blink one by one within a gap of 1 second. So let's say we have 4 LEDs, LED 1, LED 2, LED 3, LED 4. Then we will write a program that will first switch on LED 1, then 1 second gap, then switch off LED 1 and switch on LED 2, then again 1 second gap, then switch on LED 3 and switch off LED 2, then again 1 second gap, and then switch off LED 3 and switch on LED 4, and then again 1 second gap, and then again switch off LED 4 and switch on LED 1, and then same process continues forever. Okay, you must be wondering why we are using breadboard and external LEDs. Why not use the 4 LEDs already present on the discovery board? Well, we could do that, but in future tutorials, we will be using some external electronic components and we will be connecting them using breadboard and wires. So we should understand how to work with breadboard and wires, and also learning to use them could be useful in many ways, as you will not be limited to only discovery board. You can extend the board and create many cool applications. We will be doing that in future tutorials also. So just go on with me and learn. Okay, so before we go on and set up the circuit on the breadboard, let's first understand how connections we have to make. Let's say we have 4 LEDs here. Then we have our discovery board here. In this board, we have many pins. We will use 4 pins. Let's say we have PD0, PD1, PD2 and PD3. Now we need to connect these pins to the positive side of each LED. So we will connect PD0 to LED 1, PD1 to LED 2, PD2 to LED 3 and then PD3 to LED 4. Now we have ground pin also on the discovery board. Now our each LED negative sides will be connected together and will be connected to the ground pin of the discovery board. So this is the circuit we will build. But there is one problem. The pins cannot be directly connected to the LEDs because the pins give high current. And these small LEDs, although will work, but continuously working on high currents can damage the LEDs. So we will have to add one resistor here on each LED connection. These resistors can be any value between 220 ohm to 330 ohm, depends on the current rating of the LEDs, but within this range all LEDs will work. So this is the final circuit that we will build now on the breadboard. So let's start. Okay, so now we need to set up 4 LEDs and connect them to Discovery board. Before this, let me show what things we will be needed. We will need this breadboard. Then connecting wires like this, female to female header pin and male to male header pin. Actually, I will connect these two wires so that we can get a female header pin to a male header pin. If you found a single wire where it's already a female to male, then it's good. Otherwise, this will also work. Then we need 4 LEDs like this. If you notice, then you can see that one side is longer than the other side of this LED. It will actually indicate something. This longer side means it's positive side, and this shorter side means negative. Then we need resistors like this. As I already mentioned that why we needed resistors. We need 4 resistors for each LED. Okay, so now let's first understand the breadboard. In this, we have holes over here and here. Now these holes are connected together horizontally. So on each line, we have 5 holes and each one is connected together. And in the side, we have holes over here. So on each vertical line, these are connected together like this. You may find a different looking breadboard when you buy them, but don't worry, overall the things are same. Now let's start connecting the things and build the circuit. So first, put the LEDs one by one on the Discovery board. The positive side will be on this side and negative side will be on the other side here. Now put the resistors here one by one for each LED. Now let's connect the Discovery board pin here. Let's first connect the PD0 to this first LED. You can see that the wire is coming from Discovery board to this resistor, and then from this resistor it is going to LED. Same for other LEDs, PD1 to LED2, PD2 to LED3 and PD3 to LED4. Now all pins are connected to LEDs. Next is we need to connect the ground pin. So here we have a ground pin on the discovery board. So we will connect this to this line where all the LEDs negative side are connected. And we also need a wire to connect this part to this part so that ground will be common on all LEDs and discovery board. Okay, so now our circuit is built and complete. Now we need to write the program for the board. Now we have to write the program to make all the four LEDs blink one by one with 1 second gap. Let's create a new project. Let's name it LED Program 2. Okay, so now I am creating the new project using the same steps that we have followed earlier. If you are not sure what I am doing here, then check out my previous tutorials. There I have already explained the steps. Let's now change the clock settings. We need to correct the clock settings as we have 8 MHz external crystal on the discovery board and at all if True Studio by default set this up for 25 MHz external crystal. This we have already discussed in the previous tutorial. So if you are not sure what I am doing here, then please see my previous tutorial. Okay, so now clock settings are configured properly now. Also, let's delete all the comments. Okay, so now we have a complete new project with properly configured clock settings. So first we need to configure and initialize the pins on the microcontroller as GPIO where the external LEDs are connected. So we need to define this type. Then we need to mention the pin numbers. Now in the previous tutorial, we were working on only one pin, that's PD12. So at that time, we have written only GPIO pin 12 here. But on this program, we will work on 4 LEDs. And thus, we have 4 pins here and we need to write like this. We can write as many pins here until they are all belong to same port. As we have connected all 4 LEDs to port D, hence we can write like this. Now set other values. These are same like we have done in the previous LED program. Now initialize them by calling this function. Okay, so now we have initialized the GPIO pins where LEDs are connected. Now we need to write the logic to switch on and off the LEDs in a proper sequence. We will first switch up the LED 1 connected to PD0. then add a delay. Let's add the delay function body also at the top. Then switch on the LED 2 connected on pin 1 and switch off the LED 1 connected to pin 0. Then again delay. Then again same process. And after this last delay statement, our program will again start from the top and switch on LED 1. But here we'll have to add a line to switch off the LED 3 also. There is one more thing that we need to do. We need to start the clock at the port D. Okay, so now our program is complete. Let's build this program and run it. Okay, so now we have built the project and run it. You can see now that our code is started running and our all LEDs are blinking one by one. That's great, our program worked. So you can see that how we can connect external components to Discovery board using the breadboard and create some cool things. Okay guys, in this tutorial we have learned about breadboard and how to use them, how we can create external circuit and connect them to microcontroller on the Discovery board. Then we have created a program to switch on 4 LEDs one by one. In the next tutorial we will learn about a new mode that's called input mode. Till now we are just using the output mode to switch on LEDs, but in the next tutorial we will use a switch to light LEDs on and off. Once again, this is Anupam from logicvoltage.com and thanks for watching. Bye.